Welcome to everyone at the workshop Let's Talk Computer with our two wonderful workshop leaders, Michiel Koelink and Arida Wandringa. And Michiel is founder of the organization Arctic Lab, and he's course director of the Master Arts Education in Groningen, the Netherlands. And Arida Wandringa is the owner of the Dutch company Educatief Ontwerp Lab, Educational Design Lab. And she teaches art at the Gemeentelijk Gymnasium, a secondary school in Hilversum, the Netherlands too. Now, I would love to invite Michiel and Arida for the workshop and possibly to show some of their results during the wrap up of the symposium. So I wish you all a lovely workshop and enjoy the coming hour.
Thank you so much. So let's try to share a screen first. Welcome everybody. Thank you for inviting us, Melissa and the whole Wicked Arts Assignments team. We have 1 hour, which is a lot of time, also not much. So we're gonna jump right into it. Let's see. This is a bit what we're planning to do. We have a 15-minute introduction, 5 minute explanation of an assignment we made for you, then working on that assignment, everybody, for 30 minutes. Arida and me will stay in the Zoom. Everybody will stay in because otherwise you have a hard time getting back into it, but we are there for technical support and hands-on feedback, etc., and then 10-minute recap. So that's our plan. And if you cannot see us, on the left, it's me. Thank you for the introduction. And on the right is Arida. Maybe to add to your introduction, Melissa, Arida is also a member of Arctic Lab and one of my main partners in figuring out how to integrate art, science, and technology in the art educational curricula in Holland.
Yes, thank you. Hi, I'm Arida. This workshop is about connecting with AI by a dialogue. When Michiel and I prepared this workshop, we thought we could see everyone. But when we share a screen, it's not, but you can still participate in this warming up. We're going to show you some theses about artificial intelligence. If you want to participate and you're on screen, you can say yes with open hands or say no, and you can make a cross with your arms. The first thesis we like to show you, I trust on artificial intelligence. If you say yes, make this gesture, or no, make this one. Okay. The second one is...
Let me just stop sharing for 1 second. I think I figured it out, Arida.
Okay.
So now you see the presentation and you see yourself?
A few. Yeah, I see myself.
Yeah, a few. All right.
Oh, you can see. Okay. Well.
Second one.
Okay, second one. Artificial intelligence makes people lazy and stupid. If you say yes, put your arms like this. If you say no, make a cross. I see a few crosses. Okay, very good. Next one. We are in control of artificial intelligence. I see some crosses, I see some doubt. Okay, cross, hands on, yeah, okay. Or the next one, artificial intelligence controls us. Also some doubt. Okay, the next, and now we are going to get somewhere. Is it possible for you to have a love affair with artificial intelligence? Some say yes, some say no, some are in doubt still. Okay. This was a warm up to give you a little bit of thought about AI and how you respond to it. And Michiel will take it over from here.
Yeah, so artificial intelligence is something that is happening in the world that that is influencing us as a society, as a individuals, in multiple ways. And it's one of the examples that we think is an interesting development in the world that we should pick up in art education. So this is the main question that we have as Art Tech Lab Amsterdam. Is it not strange that there is a lot of inspiring art that integrates science and technology, and that we only see little of this art in education? Just shortly introducing ourselves, Art Tech Lab is part of the Breitner Academy, and the Breitner Academy is part of the Amsterdam University of the Arts, and we are funded by the Dutch Creative Industries Network, Amsterdam Creative Industries Network, which is a community of labs in Amsterdam, and we are the only educational lab in that setting. We teach a course in the teacher training program at the Breitner Academy. So these are first and second year students that will become art teachers or art educators in a broader field. We've been giving this course for 7 years already, have reached about 300 students. 200 of those are working in the Dutch professional arts educational field. And this course is quite a big chop of the first and the second year, which is 16 full days in total. So we really have an opportunity to train young professionals and get them acquainted with this art, science, and technology field. And next to these courses in the curricula, we also do a lot of teacher training, lifelong learning for art, science, and technology educators, in which we try to visit venues in Holland that are dealing with this. On the right side, we are looking at an image from training that we did at Stedelijk Museum Amsterdam, when there was an exhibition with Tangeli as an old kinetic sculpture biomass, and also a design exhibition that was focused on how design changes the world. We just a quick reminder, we have an upcoming art training starting in January 21st. It's in Dutch, unfortunately, for this audience, but we will keep giving training also in an online setting the coming months. Arida.
Okay. Here you see a few kits we are using in our educational field. These kits are get children acquainted with technology on a very low profile basis. They're trying to make a robot. They're trying to connect with computer and interact with the Makey Makey. It's really intuitive to use, and children get acquainted with technology on an easy way. We also participated in the next slide with the Art Science Database, and we wrote for the Art Science Database a few lessons. The whole website is filled with art on the intersection between science and technology. Each artwork you see is described, explained, and contains an art assignment you can try in your educational field. It's also added some questions to stimulate critical thinking, and you will find resources to dig deeper into the topic of the artist. He's using some kind of technology, and you can dig deeper into the topic with the resources on the page. And this is used only in the Netherlands for now, but for the English speaking participants, we are trying to translate this also in English, so there's more people can use this website.
And it's written in a language that we think is suitable for most students in secondary education already. So that teachers can already use it very easily in their lessons and don't have to rewrite the content.
Yes.
Let me check. So we think that art helps us think more deeply about our fast-changing technology and science-driven society. We think that art makes it apparent how important it is to question and criticize these developments in our society. And maybe most important, art can help support us in developing a critical personal position with regard to our fast-changing society. And this society changes so fast under the influence of development for a big part in technology and science. So let's talk computer, make an artwork in dialogue with artificial intelligence. We have an assignment which is called Chinese Whispers and Artificial Intelligence. And this assignment, I think everybody's familiar, you are in a circle, one kid or one adult shares a thought with the one next to him in his ear, and she gives it on, he gives it on, and so forth. And by the end that you're back, the whole idea has changed, because every time that you give the thought over, it will, slowly mutate into a different thought. So this work is an assignment is based on the work of Marijn Bolink, Google's Eyes from 2016. And in this work, Marijn Bolink took a picture from Google that he found of a tire, and he made a ceramic replica of this tire. That's the first sculpture. After this, he made a photograph of the scope of the ceramic tire and handed this photograph to Google and asked Google for similar images. And when he did that, he found a picture of a human jaw bone, and he made this jawbone in ceramics, took a photograph, handed it to Google, and looked for similar images and found a human fist, etc. And in this way, he had a dialogue with the highly evolved image recognition software system of Google. And I think it's a beautiful example of an artist that has a creative dialogue with a super advanced AI, not using AI on the technical level, but more on a intuitive level. Now, what is artificial intelligence really? We talk about it a lot. It's up for grabs. Also, there are a lot of different explanations, but we'll say for now, artificial intelligence or AI is the ability of computers to perform tasks for which people use their intelligence. Think of observing, recognizing, interacting with the environment, analyzing, reasoning, solving problems, and predicting. Examples of artificial intelligence in everyday life: Google searches, Bing, Yahoo. Don't know if anybody uses Yahoo anymore, but this goes fast. Autocorrect and word suggestions, navigational software, what you do and you don't see on social media, matching, dating sites, job sites, Uber, LinkedIn, which matches are made, autoplay, for example, in Spotify. Also, of course, which movies do you get in your front screen when you're visiting Netflix, smart assistants like Siri, Alexa, Bixby, online banking and fraud detection, and tickets and hotel prices. So there's almost no way to avoid interacting with these systems. And I think this is one of the examples that everybody's jumped into. You are writing messages and the autocorrect function of your WhatsApp changes a word in this way. I'm dumping you when I get home instead of I'm jumping you when I get home. And this, yeah, there's a whole subreddit dedicated to screen grabs from these autocorrect fails. That brings it home very fast. This is a Tesla driver on autopilot. It's like a shot from the future. This is no longer science fiction, but reality, being driven automatically to your work while sleeping. This is an artwork from the Google Arts and Cultures experiments. And this is based on the idea that everybody in the world is connected by a couple of handshakes. And here they connect artworks by a couple of steps. And they will always look for a visual overlap between the artworks. Of course, there's also all kinds of new imagery coming out. There's all kinds of artists working with Deep Dream Generator and all kinds of available systems to create new portraits, new images, new artworks. This is the Bellamy family. This was one of the most highly priced paintings by a French group of artists, which sold surprisingly for almost 400,000 euros in 2018. They made a series of artworks and had an algorithm that based these artworks on a whole collection of images from art history, from portraits from art history. And this is a work by Bemo Akten, I think one of the really interesting artists working in this field. And maybe to really slow it down, on the left side you see input from the webcam as the computer camera sees it, the webcam sees it. This is the raw input. And on the right is how does an AI system see the world if everything it's ever seen before this moment are images of the sea? How will it interpret the feed from the webcam as all it, when all it knows are images from the sea? So I think this we put all these examples in it to give some kind of a relevance that we like to give to our students and pupils, but also to you right now, of the maybe the relevance of thinking about AI, interacting with AI, and getting a feel for what these systems are or could be. So Arida.
Yes. Now we're going to start with the fun part, because you can participate in this workshop. We're going to do the assignment similar like the Chinese whispers Michiel mentioned earlier. You need pencil, crayon, markers, etc. What's on your desk. We're going to start all with the same picture, image, we show it later. You draw this picture, this image. You can use Google Lens or Pinterest for uploading it to the internet. If you use Google's Lens, you have to use the app and not your Safari app on your iPhone. If you go to Google, then you don't see the lens. So you have to really use your app. You can upload a photo into the app and he chooses similar images from your own drawing, and you choose one of those images and you're going to copy this image and then you repeat. We have created a Padlet Here you see the URL, and we also going to copy the URL in the chat.
This is also for giving some images to Melissa at the end of the day. So please add your results here.
Yeah. And you can also use the QR code. We are showing, we're going to show you this slide later on again. Well, this artwork of Marijn Boling, the Dutch artist Michiel mentioned earlier, is an inspiration of this assignment. We're also showing this to our students, this artwork. This is a traditional artist, cult sculptor, who got interested in technology and AI in particular. If we have some tips for your drawings, for the assignment, to get a good dialogue with the AI, these are the tips. Line drawings do not work so well. Just use bigger colored pieces in your drawing. Scroll a little further to an interesting image. So you can use the first similar image for what's popping up, but you can also scroll a bit down to look for an interesting image. Do not include text, work fast. 5 minutes per drawing, and write down the order of your drawing. In the next slide, you see you can scroll down a bit. And now you're also very curious, what's your starting point? Well, we're going to show it right now. Here you see the image you have to draw first. You are going to draw this image, and you're going to take a picture of your drawing. You uploaded the drawing as a photo to the artificial intelligence system like Google Lens or Pinterest. Choose an image, draw the image, and repeat. And you have two options, or you can upload all the images at the end of your dialogue, but maybe it's a bit more cool to see the process you're in, the dialogue you're in. So maybe it's also nice to upload your drawings once at a time.
The Padlet.
In the Padlet. We are going to show the Padlet later in about approximately 10 minutes. So you can first draw this one, and then we show you the slide of the Padlet so you can go to the Padlet. Are there questions about the assignments? You can put them in the chat. Yeah, the picture is also in the Padlet already, so you can also put on the Padlet on screen.
So you can use this URL, or you can use the
QR codes.
QR codes. We will stay here, and I do not see the chat, so you can also, if you have questions, you can also ask them in audio. We will be back together in the main room here at, we are a little over time.
5:05?
Yeah, 5:05, and we have 10 minutes for recap.
Yeah.
So have fun. Mostly this is a lot of fun, and we'll be back in a couple of, in 25 minutes. Have fun.
Have fun.
And I think it's good when I go back to the starting image now.
Someone is asking for the link. Maybe you can copy it in the
chat. I will put it in the chat. It's a very clever idea. I'll be back in a sec. Yes.
Yes, cool.
This image is one of the pieces that is used in the Breitner Academy. We are a very old art educational academy in Amsterdam for art. And this is being used in the drawing studios for training purposes. We have no idea how long this has been in our collection, but pretty long. If it's not working for you, please ask us. Arida, are you in the Padlet?
People are fast, Michiel, but not that fast, so.
No, but I'm just wondering if you are in the Padlet. Oh,
okay.
See a lot of concentrated faces and drawing happening when I scroll through the participants. We'd love to see the results from Melissa also, of course.
I have a question.
Yes.
Is Google Lens an app that I can download on my phone? Because I'm not finding it.
Yeah, it's an app.
You can see here the app. I don't know if you see my. Oh wait. Yeah, I'm not on mute. Do you see the app? Just the Google app. So you have to download it.
And what do they do in Google Apps then, Arida?
When you open it, you will see the lens here. It's just that tiny square.
I found it. I was looking for something called Google Lens, but
You
downloaded was the Google app, right?
Yeah.
Yes. I'm downloading it now.
I don't understand. What is the name of the app we're downloading?
It's just Google.
It's just Google.
Okay.
So if we have Google, then we just go to... I'm in Google, but I'm not sure.
If you are in Google, you will see a tiny square symbol in the search box, search thingy. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And you can, if you click on it, then you can take a picture.
It will open the camera and you can take a picture.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
But this function is also integrated in Pinterest. With their own search engine, which works a bit different, of course, but not necessarily the interface with the app, but can you see me here? I don't see myself.
Yeah.
So if you are in Pinterest and you... I have to stop my my background is... fucking with me. If you go to Pinterest and you press the search icon on the top right, you can write a search question, but you can also hit the camera button and then you can photograph something and Pinterest will give you its ideas about your photograph.
I'm just having trouble getting this, finding my you know, that grid in Google on my phone. I always find it on my computer, but I can't access that because of the screen sharing. Does anybody have any ideas what I could do to be able to access Google?
Because you're in Zoom. Is that it?
Yeah. Well, wait a minute. Yeah. I just don't want to leave the meeting.
Can you open a different tab?
What? Or I guess I could do it, go down to the dark side and do Pinterest. I'll do that.
The dark side. Mm-hmm. Well, those are good questions. Is there a bright side?
How do we then upload images to the Padlet?
You can, there's a pink cross at the bottom.
Ah, yes, I see.
Okay.
So if you upload your picture to Pinterest, should you only choose one new drawing or can you choose several?
Hey, Lily.
Hey, Michiel, hey. Sorry, nice, I was even in the WC and to miss tickets. Hey.
Yeah, if you find one image, you draw it.
Yes, I did it.
And then you take put a picture of that. And then search for one image that you think is interesting to you or you're surprised by.
Draw that one again. One,
and then repeat.
Thanks.
Michiel?
Ja, Anne?
Dan weet je, dan delen we dus niet het plaatje wat je tussendoor gevonden hebt met jullie.
You only share your images that you draw, not the images that you found. Only your own work.
Okay.
Yeah. It's actually a good question, Anne. For now, this is the answer, but maybe in the future we should incorporate that. There are some questions in the chat also.
Yes, I'm answering.
Thank you.
There are some beautiful drawings already on the Padlet.
Can we go there, you think?
Yeah, sure.
Let me just go out of the meeting.
Excuse me. Can you share with us the Padlet link?
It's in the chat already.
I can put it again in the chat so that you don't have to search for it.
Okay, thank you.
It's there. Oh, nice.
Someone is asking to show you the app from Google again. I'm showing it to the camera. In the search bar, you see the little square image. You can hit on it.
Ja, ik zie wat je bedoelt, maar ik zie hem dus niet in mijn app. Ik heb die app net gedownload, maar ik heb alleen maar een of ander microfoontje en verder niks eigenlijk.
Oh, dat is wel vreemd. Moment.
Dat is gewoon de Google app, toch?
De Google app, zou je zeggen, ja.
Ja. Oké,
okay,
goed.
Heb je Pinterest voor nu?
Nee, maar kan ik wel proberen.
Arida?
Ja.
Ik zie dat wij in die Padlet, dat die dingen niet onder elkaar komen van dezelfde mensen die het... Dus ze kunnen niet ermee slepen, hè?
Nee, ik kan even kijken of ik de grid aan kan passen.
Ja, dat is eigenlijk leuker dat we setjes zien hoe ze...
Ja, ik weet niet of dat gaat lukken. Kan wel een...
Oh. It's really nice to see this grow.
Ik kan een tijdlijn ervan maken, maar ik...
Het is gewoon goed zo.
Ja, oké.
Ja, dat is... Oké, zo de nieuwste dingen staan boven, uiteindelijk.
Ik was nog niet zo ver. Waar kan je
foto's Monique.
Bij Google? Nige. Yay. Ik was natuurlijk weer nog niet. Ik moest andere dingen.
Heb je Pinterest?
Nee, ik zit op Google.
In Google heb je dit. Zie jij mij als ik praat?
Ja.
Oké, je hebt dit. Ik zie mezelf namelijk niet. Dat is niet zo handig. Moet ik even zo doen?
In het hoekje. Ik zag net iets in het hoekje.
Je moet het, kan jij het even laten zien, Arida?
Ja.
Sorry hoor, jongens.
Geef het
allemaal zo fijn aan het tekenen.
Je ziet... Zie je mij inmiddels?
Ja, ik zie het, maar dat heb ik allemaal niet.
Dat heb je niet. Ik ga even kijken, want er zijn dus blijkbaar verschillende Google apps. Of het ligt aan de telefoon, denk ik. Ik ga even kijken.
Ja, ik heb gewoon... de app niet. Ik zit niet in de app, denk ik.
Je kunt Chrome downloaden en Google. Misschien heb je per ongeluk Chrome gedownload? Chrome heeft namelijk...
Ik heb Google. Nee, dat weet ik zeker.
Oké.
Maar ik heb niet dat dingetje.
So, I have a question. I photographed it in Google Lens. Then I'm trying to, you know... I'm trying to access that so I can upload it to the Padlet, but I don't know where to find the photo other than this. You know what I mean?
Okay, very good question. Use the Google app for similar images. Then you draw the similar images.
How does she get it from her phone on the Padlet?
Yeah. Then you go on the phone to the Padlet. There you see a pink cross at the bottom right. And there you can upload your drawing.
Okay, I'll try that.
For us, this is of course also an experiment in doing this in an online setting, which is totally new. But looking at the Padlet, I think we're still having a really fun result. And we can, we'll give some feedback also. Yes?
Can I ask something?
Yeah.
I uploaded my picture in Pinterest, but how do I get a new feed from that? I don't know.
If you are in Pinterest?
Yeah, I've put it in my own folder called Wicked Art, but maybe I shouldn't have done that.
If you take the picture from your drawing.
Yeah, I did.
The minute you take it, you see at the bottom more like this. And you can scroll up and then you see all kinds of other images.
Oh, okay. I'll try again then.
You take a new picture. And once you take the picture, you get the option for more results. More like this.
You can also tap on the picture and then use the little, how do you call it? You can look through, looking glass.
Ah, the looking glass.
Yeah. And then you get different
Oh, wow.
Maybe you can also put a number on your drawing so we can see if it's your first, your second, or your third drawing, so we can see the dialogue a little bit.
Ah, they're already in. Oh, can they write to it? Can you write to it?
Yeah, you can put an opmerking. How do you call it?
Comment.
A comment,
you can
sure.
Post a comment to your own picture and then give it an order.
Sorry, I see a lot of different pictures, like from the little horse. Where do we get those?
You don't. People are uploading the found similar images, but you only have to upload your drawing.
Oh, okay, okay.
I will delete all the photographs of the horses.
So we have 5 more minutes, and then we'll get back to the Zoom.
I made a picture in Padlet.
Yes.
And so I don't know how to get more images.
Where did you take the picture?
I made a drawing, and yeah. I keep my drawing in front of my camera from the laptop.
Yeah.
And took a picture there.
That's a bit roundabout. So what you could have done is take a picture, put it on your desktop, save it on your desktop, and then go to Google. And if you look for images in Google, you also have an icon of a camera in the search bar. If you click on that one, you can upload your drawing from your desktop, and then it will show you similar images.
Okay. Yeah.
We can see a dialogue at the Padlet. It's going to from the horse to a unicorn to a cave rainbow. To a rainbow.
Kim Driessen.
En Arida, wil je die Padlet URL nog een keer geven?
Ja, Michiel, heb jij nog?
Will paste it again in the in the chat.
Ah, super.
I'm still having trouble understanding how to upload the image to Padlet. I have
on the bottom right side, there's a magenta, I think you would call it, as a color expert, with a little cross, a plus sign in it. Okay. And when you press on that one, you can add things.
Got it.
Mag ik nog vragen? I was the one of the horses, so I didn't understand it quite yet. What is then the... When you make the drawing and you put it in Padlet, and then what do you do?
So you make a drawing, you upload it to Google.
Yeah, or Pinterest. Or
Pinterest. Then you choose a new image from what they hand you.
Yeah.
And you redraw, and you draw that image you choose, and that's the next one you put in Padlet.
Okay.
And when the one you chose and you draw it again, then you upload it again, that result to Google. Look for similar images, draw one, and upload that result. Yeah. Oh, now we're getting into some really, really nice
things.
There's a question in the chat, Michiel. Maybe you can answer it in the recap.
What's the question? Yeah, that's a good question, Lily. Maybe you can, we get back to it in a bit. In how far do you have a personalized AI working for you right now? So Google knows so much about you, and Google is only one of many systems that is tracking you all the time. So if you draw an image, will it interpret the image differently when you search it than when somebody else with a different history with Google would search it? Super interesting. I don't know, Lily. I would think so. I think Google also knows that we are working on this together right now. Soon we'll share it with the world. So we have one more minute. We're sorry.
You can go on with your dialogue. The Padlet is still active, so if you want to upload some more drawings after the workshop, feel free.
Yeah. So here are a couple of questions that we want to focus on. What happened? Are you surprised about what happened? Do you understand the system better? Do you know how the system views the world, etc.? So while everybody's still adding to this wonderful wall, I think I'm actually really happy that we have a timeline that is from the whole group. And what we see here is that we are deviating from the horse slowly. Newts are getting into the line.
I'm glad I'm not the only one. Thank you.
Here we get to some kind of skeletons, fishes, different animals, abstract art, feet with pressure points, a hen, and of course dinosaurs.
Also a lot of Disney donkeys. So
Disney donkeys, yeah, there's a Disney donkey theme going on. Once we draw hamburgers, we always end up with My Little Pony somehow. So I'm gonna show the page again because we do want to wrap it up. In the chat, what happened? Anybody want to share their experience?
Do you want us to type it or say it?
You can say it right now because I see you already.
I thought it was really wonderful how this experience replicated the same thing that happens when you lose yourself through hyperlinks, like when you're,
you're
on a Wikipedia page and you're looking for something specific, and then all of a sudden you end up, you're like reading some article about Smokey Robinson or whatever. Yeah.
Oh, thanks. Any other comments? We can do it if people don't talk through each other, we can do it also here. But I do see Arira, can you manage the chat?
Yeah, I see the chat. Maybe you can show some student works, or I can tell a little bit about that.
Yeah, maybe we do that, seeing the time also. Yeah. So we've done this around the world by this time. 1 second. Yeah.
Yeah. In secondary school, we started with a hamburger, and we are doing this assignment for a few years now. And every time we are doing this assignment, it's really exciting if Google only sees hamburgers or it sees something else. And we are reaching the point that Google is so well trained about hamburgers, he's only showing us hamburgers at this time. So next week I'm going to do this again, this assignment, and we're going to know if Google is trained that well, or we have to start with another weird picture and then we have a dialogue. It's very interesting to do this with kids. They are very fascinating about the dialogue, what's happening with the AI and their own drawings. They are very fascinating about the dialogues, the difference between the dialogues from the different students. They are talking about AI, and they learn about this easy way how AI works and how they find results about it from it.
I think this image is really, really nice in that sense, that how the hell did the Google hand us a shirt coming from the hamburger? And so you start thinking and empathizing with the AI system. How does it see this? How does it analyze this hamburger? Is it in the cheese and the corners in the shirt? What is happening here? And from here to there, so this empathizing with the system, trying to get to know how it thinks, how it sees the world, is an integral part of the teaching, I think.
Yes.
This is in China. Different search engines there. Here I changed the assignment a little bit. And here we did the same assignment, but in the end, the students were allowed to reorder the drawings, and they would tell the story that the drawings were an illustration for. So there was an extra step added to that.
Could you explain that one more time, Michiel? This one, what you did different?
Yeah, so they were allowed to change the order of the... So normally it's a timeline, but you could also see it as input for a story that has not been written yet, and that they are the illustrations for the story, and they would also tell the story for.
Yeah.
But then they had a bit more time for the assignment. So I think seeing the time, what is the time?
Yeah.
5 more minutes.
So can AI be a creative partner? How would you use AI in art education, or different questions more focused on the educational part? I'm going to also put the chat in here. Yeah.
Michiel, I had this very interesting experience that my drawings brought me to some kind of Japanese style, and from there to origami. So the last picture I was working on, I didn't include it, but that was really like it brought me from drawing origami, and that was interestingly puzzling. It's like, should I go origami now or horse drawing? So it's interesting, confusing how to deal with these representations of your artwork in this workshop. It's really fascinating.
Could also be a question like, when would you use this? You could also see it as a creativity assignment to jumpstart a creative process when you're stuck, or to have different ideas. I think that would be a different use.
I think it would be great to use it as like an inspiration for maybe different mediums you can use. You can upload one of your maybe drawing or painting, and it will give you maybe a different medium that you can attach to that idea.
Yeah.
It's the same like the Marijn Boling did. He uploaded a 3D object and got a picture out of it. Yeah. So you can also do it with 3D objects.
So when we have more if we have more time with the students, this is an assignment you can do in a 1.5 hour lesson, maybe even an hour lesson. But if you have a series of lessons, what we did was to use this as a getting to know the assignment moment, and then after that there was the general question, make an artwork in dialogue with a artificial intelligence system, and then they could maybe make sculptures or come up with something that we never thought of. So that we did also, but we didn't include that in today's session.
Well for me it reminds me of it reminds me to some old-fashioned dadaistic ways of working.
Yeah.
I could also, in a lesson, make the historical reference. That's what I really like about it. And then
like it's
a way to include, well, it's not coincidence in a traditional way, but it's also, you have an external input that you cannot control, which makes it... very interesting to open up students for using coincidence in their work.
Yeah, thank you. That's exactly what we also, it's a, like a modern way of, it adds to all these systems that are already there.
Yeah.
And now we use a different approach.
Yeah.
If you have more time in lessons, we also try to have a critical dialogue. So for example, we have a small documentary from the Dutch Broadcasting Association that explains the whole way the Chinese social credit system works right now. That is primarily based on facial recognition, pattern recognition, AI, and gives the inhabitants of China credits for their social status. And we have to leave the breakout room in 55 seconds. So we can also have a critical dialogue about this. So thank you all very much for participating.
Yes, thank you.
We are going to share the platform. We're going to share.
Thank you
so
much.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much, Maria.
Thank you, bye.
Thank you, bye.
That was a blast.